The Gordon Terminal lit up the night. It was a 60,000 square foot building, and part of it was five stories high. Large tanks of oil were burning, plus 30,000 cases of small plastic oil jugs. Explosions sent containers rocketing.
Pacific, shut the two lines down. They want to change nozzles.
The first company on scene penetrated the building with an interior attack, but it was quickly pulled back by an arriving battalion chief. It became a tough defensive fire. The Gordon complex was nestled near Exxon Corporation. Exxon has a salt water hydrant system, and good use of that system was made as heavy streams of water were applied to the fire and to exposures. A New York fireboat stationed itself in a nearby slip to add more streams to the fight. Runoff from the firefight was eventually diverted to a diked area for cleanup. The fire raged through the night, but it was stopped from extending beyond the warehouse. The morning light left the Bayonne Bridge shrouded in smoke. Because of the concrete construction of the building, it was tough to extinguish the fire completely. Firefighters would remain on the scene for a week. Bayonne firefighters say the Gordon Terminal fire pointed to the importance of using large diameter hose and having a number of deluge sets available.